There is unquestionable and inalienable right for Israel, for any sovereign nation, to respond in a self-defensive measure, as Israel has done in circumstances where there has been a relentless bombardment. The law is irrefutable. Israel has the inalienable and sovereign right to defend its citizens, to thwart the incessant rocket fire. So when we're looking at Israel's response, essentially, it boils down to what we call the laws of armed conflict. And there's three really stems to that: the principle of necessity, the principle of distinction, and the principle of proportionality. And here, all three are met. In terms of necessity, Israel doesn't have a choice. Israel is in an intolerable situation, daily rocket bombardments. You can only imagine what would the UK do. What would you do if you were sitting right now in London and they were firing at you every single day, rockets from Manchester or Liverpool or Sussex? The UK would not tolerate it. Israel will not tolerate it. It is simply an unacceptable situation. So we saw just in the last 24 hours, of course, the Israeli troops have gone into Lebanon. So there is that necessity. There is a necessity to stop the rocket fire. There is the necessity to enforce the UN Security Council Resolution 1701, which required Hezbollah to vacate southern Lebanon, which they had not done so, and of course for Israel to return the citizens safely back to the north. So you have the principle of necessity there. You then have the principle of distinction, which requires all parties to an armed conflict when you're engaging, to separate between civilians and combatants. Again, I go back to principle four, whereas Hezbollah intentionally hides behind Lebanese civilians or targeting Israeli civilians, Israel targets solely Hezbollah targets. And that includes the Hezbollah leadership, which is legal under international law, because again, someone like Hassan Nasrallah, for example, he isn't, he's not just a pencil pusher, so to speak. This is a person who is at the head of this terrorist organization and is involved in planning, executing and ordering all these terrorist actions. And again, Israel's also targeting the rocket firing infrastructure, the Hezbollah leadership, and even if we want to talk the pages of walkie-talkies, which have been attributed to Israel, but of course not confirmed, even that we know something was being used only by Hezbollah terrorists as a form to communicate amongst themselves in order to plan, execute and carry out terrorist attacks. And of course, the last principle is that of proportionality, which probably I would say in the discussion of international law is not only the most misused principle, but something that has been so reflexively used to cast Israel as an aggressor. We can say, what is a proportionate response when 10,000 rockets have been fired at you? Should Israel just fire 10,000 rockets as it wants, wherever it wants in Lebanon? Of course not. When we had 12 Druze children who were massacred while playing football just a few months ago by Hezbollah rocket, what is a proportionate response to that? Should we fire at a kid's playing school in Beirut? Of course not. Proportionality, it's not some kind of quid pro quo or some kind of perverse equivalence in death tolls. It is not that. Very simply, proportionality requires that when you undertake a military action, there is a consideration of expected loss of civilian life as compared to what is the military objective. And again, the military objective here is very clear. It's to thwart the rocket attacks by Hezbollah. It's to force them to withdraw from southern Lebanon and to allow the Israelis who've been forcibly displaced from the north to return home. Now, that is by any stretch of the imagination, it is a legitimate military objective. But yet Israel is the only country who has been systematically, repeatedly denied the right to achieve victory, who has been castigated with acting disproportionately every time we respond. So again, when you look at these principles, again, by any stretch of the imagination, the Israeli forces have gone above and beyond to a level really that we haven't seen in modern warfare, not by the British troops, not by the American troops, really not by any troops anywhere in the world. And it also puts the Israeli forces at risk as well. That is the extent Israel goes, because quite frankly, Israel cares more about civilians in Gaza and Israel cares more about civilians in Lebanon who are being used as pawns by their own rulers, leaders, and terrorist organizations who claim to speak in their name.